Hello everyone, in this special video we are here to discuss about an influential and big silent film actor during the roaring 20s. His name is Lon Chaney. Leonidas Frank Chaney was born April 1st, 1883, by his mother and father, who are both deaf-mute people, in Colorado Springs, Colorado. Early on in his life, he would own a theater company with his brother John. He would learn to master pantomime thanks to his parents' condition as a way to communicate, and he would later use this in his big acting career. He at first worked as a performer during the 1900s in a local opera house. He would marry twice and only have one child, Lon Chaney Jr. Chaney would get to act in many shorts during the early and mid-1910s, but in 1919, his big break came along as he starred in The Miracle Man in a big role as a con man. That same year, he met Todd Browning, as they would work together for many years to come, starting with The Wicked Darling in 1920. His most famous roles wouldn't come until the early 1920s, where he began to work in horror films. His first role in the category was Quasimodo in The Hunchback of Notre Dame. He would have to wear pounds of makeup that would only be done by him only. This would later be contributed into his biggest role as Eric in The Phantom of the Opera in 1925, where he got to show his best work as a leading actor and makeup artist. In 1927, one of his other films, London After Midnight, would become a lost film after a warehouse fire that burned many of the prints. To this day, it would only come up as screenshots and tiny clips of that very film. Chaney had his last starring role in The Unholy Three in 1930, where it would be his first and last speaking role in his entire career. Earlier, he was diagnosed with lung cancer and died of it on August 26, 1930.
like it, Doctor.
Thank you. Now, folks, if you'll just gather around a little closer now, come right in a little closer. That's it. That's fine, folks. Now, then, if you'll be real quiet, I'll see if I can get the little boy to say something. Well, how are you today, Tommy?
Oh, I'm feeling fine, thank you.
Well, that's fine. Now, what are you going to sing for the folks today?
She was a butterfly's daughter.
Oh, he's going to sing She Was a Butterfly's Daughter.
She was a butterfly's daughter. But he was a son of a bee.
His impact towards the world inspired and influenced many actors, makeup artists, and directors in the coming years as they would try to use elements and pieces of Chaney's performances and various techniques to making something grand and special. His films would be recognized in film history as the most influential and inspiring out of everything during the 1920s.